Are you unsure about the differences between cloud TPU nodes and cloud TPU VMs, or how to decide which one to use for your specific needs? Join us in this hands-on introduction video as we introduce these two powerful accelerator options in Google Cloud Platform, uncovering their key distinctions and how to effectively use and optimize them for your AI and ML workflows. We'll illustrate similarities and differences in the console, including an introduction to their interaction with other Google Cloud services. For instance, Google Kubernetes Engine currently integrates only with Cloud TPU nodes, while the Vertex AI Suite prioritizes the latest Cloud TPU VM format. Note that the Python code, YAML configurations, and diagram file from this demonstration are provided in the video description. Let's proceed to the Google Cloud Console and navigate to the Cloud TPUs section within Compute Engine to fire up some sample instances. Somewhat confusingly, the Create TPU Node option enables us to provision TPUs with either architecture. We'll create a TPU node in US Central 1B, along with a TPU VM in the same zone. As these provision, let's walk through a TPU architecture diagram to differentiate between these two systems. TPUs, like their GPU counterparts, necessitate a host-machine integration. TPU nodes diverge from TPU VMs due to the direct SSH access provided with VMs. With TPU nodes, we can only tap into the accelerators via gRPC calls. Requiring network calls for accelerator utilization is suboptimal, and the TPU VM format is usually the top pick for performance. This format facilitates comprehensive control and access at root level, maximizing accelerator usage. Returning to our cloud console, we see that both the TPU node and TPU VM are ready. Firing up the Cloud Shell will illustrate the TPU VM functionality. After executing the TPU VMs list command, SSH accessible TPUs are visible. This TPU VM, unlike its TPU node counterpart, can optionally have an external IP. Once inside the VM, we'll run a few quick commands to validate our connection to the TPU. Using JAX, we can confirm that the TPU cores are up and running. Whether manually executing SSH commands or utilizing automated frameworks, the low-level control of TPU VMs is superior to TPU nodes. For the latter, we'll need to call the internal IP through gRPC calls, typically using a library or framework. To underline how managed services and serverless offerings rely on these different architectures, we'll demonstrate Google Kubernetes Engine reliance on TPU nodes, its only supported TPU architecture. We have an active Kubernetes Engine instance here. This standard cluster includes an enabled cloud TPU feature. After securing the cluster credentials, we can submit a workload. Presently, the cluster is empty, but we'll submit a pod creation command for experimentation. This command initiates an indefinitely sleeping TensorFlow pod. Our annotations and resource limits specify 8 cores of TPU V2. On checking this pod, we see the Cloud TPU provisioning step. This provisioning process can even be tracked on the TPUs page in Compute Engine. Note that this is still a standard Kubernetes cluster with non-accelerator compute used for Kubernetes nodes. We are using general purpose compute to call accelerator equipped compute, which is out of our direct control via gRPC. Once the TPU is running, we'll have a pod that we can use. If we jump into a Python interpreter here and get the value that's automatically provided as an environment variable for our TPU endpoint, we'll see that this again is a network-based approach to accelerator utilization using the gRPC protocol. Indeed, the IP we see here is the same one that we see on the TPUs page. Unless you have a unique use case or need to use a service that only integrates with TPU nodes, you should really focus on TPU VMs. The latest TPUs are being released on the VM side. Further, of the two architecture options, most managed Google Cloud services are going to use TPU VMs, so that should definitely be your focus as you move forward. In any case, we hope that you now have a basic understanding of both of these two options. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.